what was most interesting to me when moving from, let's say, a homebrew setting to mashing here is that the dough-in process doesn't take 2 or 3 minutes. You know, as long as it takes to mix water and grain, our dough-in process, which is the actual time where the grain meets the water, is around half an hour. And so that's spent, you know, hand stirring this grain that's mixing with water for half an hour. And during that time, we're trying to keep a water to grist ratio that allows the water to touch all of the grain to activate those enzymes, but not be so thin that it waters down the enzymes, and not too thick that you start to create dough balls, as we call them, of pockets of unsaturated or non-wet grain that then we won't be able to access the starch from because the enzymes haven't been able to get to it to convert the starch to sugar. So during that mashing process, those are some of the things we try to be aware of. We're aware that the grain is at a particular temperature and that the water is at a particular temperature, and we want that to meet somewhere in between. So you have hotter water than you're actually shooting for on your, let's say, mash temperature, which is on average, I would say, somewhere between 145 and 160. And so as you're mixing, those are all things you're keeping in the grain. Different recipes have different mashing temperatures depending on what kind of characteristics you'd like to have. And so through that mashing process is all something, you know, that we're keeping in mind as this grain mixes. Once it's done, the diastatic power of the malt, the how many enzymes are on there, go to work, and they're actually going to work during the dough-in process because they're activated, converting that starch. We, you know, let it rest for about half an hour, and then we start the circulation process, or in the German word would be Vorlauf. This recycling or recirculation basically allows the stuff, any stuff of the grain that would come through, until we see clear liquid. And once we've seen clear liquid, the Vorlauf is complete, and we would divert that to the kettle. Then this is our Lautering. We move now into the Lautering phase, where we're rinsing with just regular water through the grain to wash off, continually wash off any residual sugars that still exist in the mash bed to wash the sugars off of the grain and divert them to the kettle.